too.
Okay, so I was part of group B and I have problem number one. So they give us this rectangle with a couple lines drawn through it, and they give us some values. So my lines were from A to E, it's 18, and then from E to B, I got 12. So as I looked at it, I realized that some of the angles in there are gonna be the same. So we have some congruent triangles in there. So like this angle, it's gonna be the same as this angle, and this angle is gonna be the same as this angle, and this angle, same as this one, the same as this one. So this triangle and this triangle are similar. And you can sort of tell that because this is the midpoint of D and C, that both the sides of this I just labeled X, and then the whole side up here is gonna be 2X. So we can sort of tell that this triangle here is gonna be twice as big as this one here. So we can match up the sides a little bit to be able to get some of the values for the smaller triangle that's in here. So we have 18 here, so we can tell that this little line is gonna be 9. And then because we have 12, we can tell that this little line is gonna be 6. So using those, we can look at some other triangles that we have going on in there. So we can use this one here, I labeled it ABC. And then I used the Pythagorean theorem for that to be able to find y, which is what I labeled as this side here. So you're using that, be very careful. The 2x, the entire quantity is squared of that side when you're doing Pythagorean theorem, so just be careful of that. And then 27 is the hypotenuse. You have to add the 18 and the 9 together, depending on what your values are, to be a little bit different. So you come to find what y equals, and then you can do Pythagorean theorem for the other little triangle in here. I labeled it CMB, so it's CMB, it's this one here. So again, do Pythagorean theorem. X and Y, you don't know either of those, but you do know this side, the hypotenuse, you have 6 plus 12 is 18. And then you get that Y as well. And then the easiest way to solve that is to just set the Y's equal to each other. So I have that work up here. So upon doing that, you can square both of them to get rid of the square roots. And then just do the work as you go down. And then you find X to equal, I found X to equal the square root of 135. And then I plugged that back in to the Pythagorean theorem equation that I used for ABC, triangle ABC. So I plugged the X value in, did all the work, and then came up with Y equals the square root of 189 as my Y value. So now we're getting close to the end. We can finally solve for area. So the area of it is going to be 2X, that value up there, times Y, the other side. So I set up sort of a little tree diagram here for you to be able to solve the radicals. So for mine, 135 splits into 5 and 27, and you can split 27 up again into 9 and 3. So 9 itself just becomes 3. And then I did 189 as well. So there's another 9 and then a 21 in there that multiply to get 189. So that other 9 also just becomes a 3. And then there's 2 3s on both of them that when multiplied together obviously gives to the square root. So then that just becomes a 3. So when you take 2 times coefficient 3, coefficient 3, coefficient 3, you get a coefficient of 54. And then that just leaves 5 and 7 left in there in the radicals. Multiply those together, you get 35 under the radical. So the answer is 54 times the square root of 35.